Hello students, welcome to this video. I am Niranjan Roy, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Canara Engineering College. In this particular video, we will try to understand what is thermal radiation in module number 3, where we will discuss about the basics of thermal radiation and what exactly the radiation means and what are the different theories behind this radiation. Okay, well, first we will understand what is thermal radiation. Thermal radiation or a radiation heat transfer is the transfer of energy across the system boundary due to a temperature difference delta T by the mechanism of photon emission or electromagnetic wave emission. So this thermal radiation or radiation heat transfer is a distinct separate mechanism from conduction and convection for the transfer of heat energy. It refers to the heat energy emitted by the bodies because of their temperatures. All bodies at a temperature above absolute zero temperature, which emit energy by a process of electromagnetic radiation. Okay, so the intensity of such radiation, which depends on which depends upon the temperature and the nature of the surface. Okay, it mainly depends temperature. The energy transfer by a radiation does not require any medium, so between hot and cold surface. Okay, so the energy transfer by radiation is the fastest in the sense, I hope all of you know the speed of light, isn't it? So it will, this radiation is also going to take place at the same rate, and it does not suffer any attenuation even in the vacuum. Okay, any disturbance. In fact, the heat transfer through an evacuated space can occur only by radiation. Okay, so for example, you can able to see here in this particular picture, when a person is sitting in front of heater or fire, he gets most of the energy by radiation. Further, it is also interesting that the radiation heat transfer can also occur only between two bodies separated by a medium that is colder than both the bodies. Okay, so for an example, the energy emitted by sun reaches the earth after traveling energy through space and extremely cold air layers at high altitudes. So the energy, so we can conclude that the energy which is radiating surface releases not continuous, but it is in the form of successive and separate packet or quanta, which is called as photons. Because the mechanism of transmission of this photon emission, unlike conduction and convection, there need not be intermediate matter to enable transmission. Okay, so there are certain theories which will explain. It is very difficult to study the actual mechanism of radiation propagation, is not fully understood yet, but some theories like Maxwell theory and Planck's theory, which are used the concepts explained in this theory is used to study the thermal radiation. So according to the Maxwell theory, electromagnetic, it is called as a Maxwell electromagnetic theory. The energy is transferred from hot body to cold body in the form of electromagnetic waves. Okay, and the electromagnetic waves which possess the energy. That means the energy which is emitted by body as a result of the change in electromagnetic configuration of atoms or molecules. Okay, so these electromagnetic waves which will transport energy like other waves, and all electromagnetic waves travel with the speed of light. Okay, so the other theory, which is a Max Planck's theory. According to his concept, the propagation of thermal radiation takes place in the form of a discrete quanta called photons. So each quantum having energy of E is equal to h into v, or hc by lambda, where h is the Planck's constant, okay, and nu is the frequency of photons, and the c is the constant. Okay, so based on these theories, we can able to understand the concept of thermal radiation. So example, dissipation from filament of vacuum tube, or heat loss through vacuum tube, or heat loss through the evacuated wall of thermos flask. These are the best examples for thermal radiation. Next, we will study about total emissive power and monochromatic emissive power. Before going to study about total emissive power and monochromatic emissive power, we will study the spectrum of electromagnetic radiation. Okay, spectrum of electromagnetic radiation. So the radiation energy in form of electromagnetic wave is emitted at all wavelengths from lambda is equal to 0 to lambda is equal to infinity. Okay, so a portion of radiation spectrum is shown in figure, where at temperatures associated with most engineering application, the bulk of thermal energy emitted by a body which lies with more with the wavelength between lambda is equal to 0.1 to lambda is equal to 100 micrometer. Okay, so for this reason, this portion of the spectrum is generally referred as thermal radiation. So the sun emits thermal radiation at an effective surface temperature of 5760 Kelvin, and bulk of this energy lies in between lambda is equal to 0.1 to lambda is equal to 3 micrometer. Okay, so therefore this spectrum is referred as solar radiation. The radiation energy emitted by the sun is in the wavelength between lambda is equal to 0.4 to lambda is equal to 0.76 micrometer. It is visible to human eye. Okay, it is visible to human eye, and therefore this spectrum is referred as visible radiation, which is termed as a light. Okay, so almost half of the solar radiation is light, which falls in the visible range, and remaining being ultraviolet and infrared radiation. Okay, so the color surface depends on its ability to reflect the radiation at certain wavelength. For an example, a surface that reflects a fraction of radiation in the wavelength ranges from 0.63 micrometer to 0.76 micrometer, while absorbing rest of the visible radiation, which appears as a red to human eye. Okay, so this is about a basic glimpse on thermal radiation, or the spectrum of electromagnetic radiation. Now we will try to discuss what is total emissive power. So all surface at temperature above absolute zero temperature which emit energy in all directions or a wide range of wavelength. So at a given temperature, the total amount of heat energy emitted by a surface in all directions over entire wavelength per unit area or per unit time is called as emissive power. Okay, the emissive power depends on the characteristics and temperatures of the surface. So we can say the total emissive power of a body E is defined as the total radiant energy emitted by a body at a certain temperature per unit time and per unit surface area at all wavelengths. So it is designated as E, and we can say emissive power is a function of emissivity into lambda into T, where the emissive power of a black body EB is termed as EB is equal to sigma into T to the power 4 watt per meter square, where sigma is the Stefan Boltzmann constant and T is the absolute temperature, where sigma Stefan Boltzmann constant is equal to 5.67 into 10 to the power minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power 4, okay, which is termed as Stefan Boltzmann constant, and T is the absolute temperature. Okay, so the spectral or monochromatic emissive power, which is the amount of radiation energy emitted by from a surface at a given temperature, which is varies with the wavelength. Okay, so monochromatic emissive power E lambda is defined as the rate of energy radiated per unit area of the surface per unit wavelength. Okay, so the total emissive power E is equal to 0 to infinity E lambda into D lambda, which is watt per meter square. So emissive power from a real surface is given by E is equal to emissivity into sigma into A into T to the power 4. Okay, next we will study about emissivity. So the radiation emitted by a real body at a temperature T is always less than that of the black body. Therefore, the black body emission is considered as a reference. So the emissivity is defined as the ratio of the radiation energy emitted by a surface to that emitted by a black body. So it is the ability of the surface to radiate heat. Okay, so it is defined as a ratio of emissive power of any body to emissive power of black body of the same temperature. So it is a dimensionless quantity and a property of radiating surface to measure how closely a surface approximates a black surface. For each epsilon is equal to 1. Okay, so emissivity, which is termed as epsilon, which is equal to E by EB, and it is designated as epsilon and varies from 0 to 1. For black body, emissivity is equal to always 1. The emissivity of real surface is not a constant. It varies with the temperature of surface as well as wavelength and direction of emission. Okay, so and therefore different emissivities may be defined for a surface depending upon the effect which is considered, like hemispherical and total emissivity, or spectral emissivity, or directional emissivity. Okay, it depends upon the various aspects. Next, we will study about irradiation, or we can say the total radiation or irradiation gene. And this irradiation is defined as the total incident radiation on a surface from all direction per unit time, per unit area surface, area of surface, okay. So the irradiation is the total radiation energy incident per unit area per unit time over entire wavelength from all directions. So it is denoted by G and measured in watt per meter square. So you can able to see the sketch. Some incident radiation, G, which strikes the material surface, and there some fraction of radiation is reflected back, and then fraction of radiation, incident radiation is absorbed, and a fraction of incident radiation is transmitted. So from this we can able to see it is converted into three different types of radiations. So some incident radiation is absorbed, some incident radiation is reflected, some incident radiation is transmitted. So according to that, for most of the surfaces, when the radiation incidents on your body, a part of it is absorbed, part of it is reflected, and remaining part is transmitted, as shown in figure. So we will study what exactly the absorptivity alpha means. A black body absorbs all incident radiation, and hence its absorptivity is considered as unity. But the real surface do not absorb all energy incident on it. The total or average or hemispherical absorptivity alpha is defined as the fraction of radiation energy incident on the surface from all direction over entire wavelength spectrum that is absorbed by the surface. Or absorptivity is the ratio of absorbed radiation to total incident radiation or irradiation on the surface. So mathematically, if we write alpha is equal to GA by G, where A stands for absorption, and this value of alpha lies in between 0 to 1. Okay, so for a black body, alpha is 1. And for real body, the value lies in between 0 to 1. So the fraction of irradiation absorbed by the surface is called absorptivity. Then a second term, it is reflection or reflectivity, which is termed as rho. It is the ratio of reflected radiation GR to total incident radiation G on the surface. Or when the radiation is incident on a non-black surface, a fraction is always reflected by the surface. The reflectivity of a surface is defined as a fraction of radiation energy incident on a surface from all direction over entire wavelength that is reflected. So it is designated as rho and is expressed mathematically. Rho is equal to GR by G, where R stands for reflection, and this value of or the value of reflectivity rho is also varies from 0 to 1, if the surface is perfectly smooth and the angle theta of incident and reflected rays is equal. So we will discuss separately in this video what are the various reflections. But anyhow, the fraction of a radiation reflected by surface is called reflectivity. Then the transmittivity Transmittivity in the sense when radiation is incident on a semi transparent surface, a part of is reflected or that means transmitted, reflected, a part of it's absorbed and remaining is transmitted. Okay, hence the transmittivity tau, it is termed as tau, is the fraction of incident energy transmitted through the surface. So mathematically tau is equal to gt by g. The value of tau is also varies from 0 to 1. So that means tau is a fraction of the radiation transmitted by a surface, which is called as transmittivity. With all these considerations for a surface, the sum of absorbed, reflected and transmitted radiation is equal to the radiation energy incident on the surface, basically Ga plus Gr plus Gt is equal to G, where A is stands for absorption, R is for stands for reflection, and T stands for transmission. So if you divide that entire equation by G, then we can get Ga by G plus Gr by G plus Gt by G is equal to G by G. That means alpha, Ga by G is nothing but alpha, Gr by G is nothing but rho, and Gt by G is nothing but tau according to the definition. So alpha plus rho is plus tau is equal to 1. So we can able to see this in data handbook in page number 82. Next we will study what you mean, the meaning of a black body or concept of a black body. A black body is defined as a body which is perfect emitter and absorber of radiation. So it has an ideal surface with some properties. So in actual there is no surface as has all properties like a black body. The at a specified temperature and wavelength, no surface can emit more energy than black body. So a black body absorbs all incident radiation, okay, all incident radiation in all directions at all wavelengths. So black body is a diffuse emitter, that is a black body which emits energy radiation uniformly in all directions per unit area normal to the direction of emission. So the term black is different from visual observations. So a surface is coated with the lamp black, appears to be black in color to human eye in visible range of spectrum, but turns out to be black for thermal radiation. Okay, so on the other hand, the ice and snow appear quite bright to human eye, but almost black to thermal radiation at all wavelengths from lambda is equal to 0 to lambda is equal to infinity. So consider a radiation beam enters the cavity of enclosure. Okay, cavity of enclosure which is shown in figure. It experiences many reflections within the enclosure, and almost entire beam is absorbed by the cavity, and the black body behavior is experienced. Okay, so therefore for a black body, alpha is equal to 1 and rho reflectivity and transmittivity is equal to 0. So where the concept of black body can be studied by a Hallam arrangement, which is shown in figure. Next we will see the certain properties of a black body. So black body is absorbs all incident radiations falling on it, so it does not transmit or reflect regardless of wavelength in and directions. It emits maximum amount of thermal radiation at all wavelengths at any specified temperatures. Any specified temperatures, it emits maximum amount of thermal radiation at all wavelengths. And it is a diffuse emitter. Therefore, for black body, alpha is equal to 1, rho and tau is equal to 0. So when no incident radiation is transmitted through the body, when no incident radiation is transmitted through the body, it is called as opaque body. So for an opaque surface, there is no transmission, and thus the reflectivity and absorptivity are alpha plus rho is equal to 1, but tau is equal to 0. Okay, and we can give some examples such as glasses and liquids for opaque body. While a body is called white body, which reflects almost all radiation incident upon it, and it does not absorb or transmit any part of it. Okay, so if all the incident radiation falling on the body are reflected, then such body is called as white body. So for white body, rho is equal to 1 and alpha and tau is equal to 0. So when it comes to reflections, there are two types of reflection. One is a regular or specular reflection, which means the angle between the reflected beam and the normal to the surface, which equals to the angle made by the incident radiation with the same normal reflection from highly polished and smooth surfaces approaches specular characteristics. Or in other words, when you use highly polished smooth surface finished materials where incident radiation is falling on it, and it causes the reflection with the same angle as that of incident radiation, which is normal to the direction. Okay, so this type of reflection is called as a regular or specular reflection, whereas the diffused reflection, there's a second type, which is diffused reflection, where the incident beam is reflected in all directions. So most of the engineering materials have rough surfaces, and these surface have a diffused reflection. Okay, so this specular reflection is also called as a mirror reflection, and the reflection from real surfaces is neither specular or not diffuse, but a combination of diffuse and specular behavior can be seen. Okay.